Some refugees in two neighboring nations, 1.2 million in Syria, 800,000 in Jordan. Another 2 million have been internally displaced in Iraq. So that's 4 million people displaced in Iraq since 2003. A similar but smaller story in Afghanistan. We do not know how many civilians have been killed because we don't even bother to count. We have stories about either drones or American bombing killing 50 people here, 100 people there. At least, according to one estimate, 30,000 civilians have been killed, not all of them by the NATO and allied forces, also by the Taliban, but at least half of them or a third of them, depending on which count you follow, civilians have been killed by the people who have gone ostensibly to put things right in Afghanistan. If you add up this total, you will find that at least between 1.2 and 1.4 million Muslims have been killed in the last 16 or 17 years. Why are we surprised that the Muslim world is in total turmoil, literally and figuratively? We don't have to look for religious reasons and Islamic reasons for it. And when people have to fight for foreign forces in their lands and then when they're being killed, and the oppressed always turn to whatever comes in handy to rally the public. And most scholars have now come around to the viewpoint that Islam and the Islamic flag, in whatever form, in distorted form or the right form, is a rallying cry for Muslims, for the oppressed to gather under and fight this battle. As simple as that. If proportionately, for example, 100,000 or 250,000 or God forbid 500,000 Canadians had been killed, what would be our reaction? What would we be saying? I mean, it's not so surprising that all this is happening in